Blackstone presents The Red Canoe by Wayne Johnson. This book is read by Milo Kingfisher. At that time, the great prince, Michael, who stands beside the sons of your people, will appear. And those who lead the many to righteousness will be like the stars, forever and ever. The Book of Daniel. For those who have been silenced, who have not been heard, who have had no voice. Fall. Chapter 1. Buck. The girl came to him on the afternoon of the day he was served for divorce, signed receipt required, and a miracle having just saved his life. He'd been in his garage shop all morning, the two-car-wide door open, building a facsimile 1880s rowboat for a software designer in Seattle when he heard the shuck of feet on his drive. "Michael Fineday," droned a man's voice from behind him, something of the herald in it. He turned from the boat to face an innocuous middle-aged guy, dressed all in black as if he might be less conspicuous that way, and his dishwater blonde, greasy hair in a side-parted comb-over. It took a moment for the name to register. It wasn't his, but when trouble came, and it had over the years, it always came to Michael. To the archangel, who Sister Seraphim, the Catholic off-reservation boarding school, had informed him, was his namesake. All these years later, four decades and counting, Michael still got out in front of him, after which all he could do was follow. "Sign, please," all in black said. He held out a clipboard and pen, pointed, "Right here at the bottom." He swept his thermos from his drafting table, poured a cup, and took the clipboard. "If you don't mind," he said, and winked, trying to make light of whatever this was now. "I'll take a look-see here before I sign away my firstborn," or center top was, "In the Third Judicial District Court," and below it, "Naomi Louise Weston, petitioner." Mo, he thought. Shit. And an explosion went off in his head. And to get some distance from it, glancing up from the page, he joked, "Dressed the way you are, how do I know you're not some whiskey priest sent out here to mess with me?" All in black held up an ID on a yellow lanyard. Magistrate of the court. He was that sort of guy. No affect was good affect. "If you would, please," he said. He'd set the clipboard on his hip, like a wing, but nothing was saving the moment, and in him that awful woodenness he'd suffered since having left Naomi's. "I sign this. That's just me agreeing you've gotten it to me and not anything else, right?" All in black nodded. "You know the old saw about the bearer of bad news, right?" Having heard it before, All in Black allowed himself the shadow of a smile, as if warding off a blow. Behind him were mock tombstones, cockeyed on lawns, ghosts in trees, and cardboard witches and vampires on stoops. Halloween was coming up. But standing in the mouth of his shop now, holding the clipboard, everything this morning seemed unreal. The odd, two bruised blue morning light, the two stillness in the air, the two hushed traffic out on the highway, that Naomi had stopped by the house days before to get a few things, as she'd put it. Photos, china, some bric-a-brac he'd mistakenly gotten in his boxes when he'd moved out in June, hadn't alarmed him. After all, it was her house in St. Paul, and given she'd told him she needed some space, he'd gotten his things together and come here, to the house his father had left him. Counting those earlier periods of adjustment, as Naomi had once jokingly called them, this was his third. But now, he glanced down at the clipboard. All that legalese, so much mumbo-jumbo. This was different. "Just sign, please," All in Black said. "Bottom right." He did that with an angry flourish, then handed the works over. All in Black grinned, tore the carbon of the petition from underneath, and officiously, nodding slightly, thrust it at him. "And what am I supposed to do with it?" he said. "Paper the walls, or—" "I got an idea. It'll come in handy in the John." "Thank you," All in Black said, and thrust the petition at him again. "And have a nice day." "And you do the same," he replied, and with a nod, he took the petition. He tossed it so it flapped, all however many—
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.